What's up, buddy?
How are you?
Oh, I'm good. Hey, it comes with a basketball hoop.
Hi.
Here it is.
Wow. Such a
looker. So Tarek and I are playing a game of horse in a little bit.
Okay.
Who do you think wins?
Me? You're going down.
Oh. You're terrible at basketball.
Oh, no, I'm not.
Wow.
I played basketball in high school, guys.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
You were a senior on the freshman team. All right, so before we check it out, it's not a big house. It's 3-bedroom, 1.5-bath. It's only 1,000 square feet. I got the key.
You in the front door.
Quiet.
Can never open a door.
As of right now, you can't.
I got us in. Okay, so first impression, you have useless space right here, and this is useless.
Well, right now, there's hardly any counter space. The kitchen feels awkward, and then you have the stove, like, in a closet. Doesn't even really make sense. It's definitely a strange layout. It feels very dark in here.
Remodeling the full kitchen, cost, what are you thinking?
Probably 10 grand.
It's a good-sized living room.
This is the family room, dining room, eating room. This is everything.
Big yard.
Use your muscles. Well, part of why it feels very dark inside is this overhang. Although it's kind of nice because it provides shade.
This is definitely not a permitted laundry room.
Unfortunately, it's going to be expensive to take it down.
Maybe 1,000.
It's creepy.
Oh, my God, it has a plastic ceiling.
That's a skylight, dude.
Here's the garage. Why did they build a platform? They put T-bar in like if it's an interior of a house.
This guy was trying to have a man cave, it looks like, but it is weird.
So this is illegal plumbing, obviously, right?
Oh,
for
yeah.
The laundry room?
Yeah.
How much do you think it costs to fix all this?
Probably 1,500 to bring it back to its original use.
What do you think it would be to get rid of the T-bar, the ceiling, the post, all that?
Maybe another 600 bucks.
All right, so over 2 grand. All right, back in the kitchen.
Keep going. Bathroom.
Ooh, fancy, 2 types of tile. And look at, they even did a custom bed.
What are we looking at here?
Maybe 6 grand.
Bedroom number one.
Oh.
Oh my gosh.
This FAU.
It's newer.
It looks like it's just an FAU. So do you want air conditioning here or no?
Yes.
What, like 3 grand out of AC?
Probably 6 to 7.
What do you mean 6 to 7? It's just air conditioning.
Oh
we already
gosh.
Have the ducting and the heat.
You need bigger ducting for AC.
Wait, guys, look at the carpet. And isn't there supposed to be 2 bathrooms?
It's a half bath, so it's gotta be in the master.
And there's a bathroom.
Okay, this is the half bath, and it's tiny. On the other side of this, that's the furnace, right?
Yeah.
How much would it be to put the furnace in the attic?
You might be another 400 bucks.
If we spend a couple $1,000 and we have an actual second full bathroom, we'll make a lot more return on it.
Definitely worth it.
What's that?
Yes. You!
Uh-oh.
Why do you just press random buttons?
How can you guys expect me not to push the button?
You're not a toddler.
It says emergency.
I know, but it's like...
Why would you touch it?
Because it's like, does it really work?
It's like a disco in here. This guy rigged up his own alarm system.
Oh, this is an alarm? This is genius. Anywhere you go, if you see something that says emergency, you have to see what that means, right?
Are you 3? Anytime you see a red button, you have to push it?
Whole neighborhood is gonna come out.
The cops will be here any minute. So.
Oh, you're right.
So what do we do?
We can either rip it out and find it or
try to find something.
Shut off the breakers.
All right.
It was that one.
All right.
So that was fun.
It was fun. It's always fun. Did we figure out what's going on?
You had a slab leak. Water was coming up through here. Moisture is causing all these pops in the concrete.
It's weird.
The house has been replumbed, so the problem is fixed. The damage caused by the problem isn't fixed. So what we need to do is clean it out, seal it, patch over it.
How much is it?
800 bucks.
All right, let's do it.
I got something else to show you outside. So when we walked the house initially, we knew that this laundry area was an unpermitted addition.
Yeah.
But when we went down to the city, it turns out the entire patio cover is unpermitted. It all needs to go.
Man, how much?
You're gonna be looking at like 1,500 bucks, minimum.
Just to take it down?
We don't know what it's gonna do to the roof once we take it down.
Oh, yeah.
So what are we gonna do, just take it down and not put anything back up?
We're so tight on this house. We paid 510, the columns are like 660.
Once it comes down, then all you're left with is this like cracky mess of concrete with literally no shade. It's gonna look like crap. Should we rebuild this patio cover?
We can't do that. We're over budget. Plus, it'll cost like $10,000 to $15,000 just to build the new one. And we have permits, so the cost is way too high.
It's just such a bummer. Can't we at least paint that slab so that it looks nice?
We can do that.
Gosh,
Oh, wow.
It's like a war scene.
So the way that they did that patio cover was they roofed from the roof, over the roof, onto the patio cover directly. So once we took down your laundry room, patio cover, you're left with
a bunch of crap.
Mm-hmm.
It looks horrible.
All right, I'm gonna ask, how much is it gonna be to fix that?
It'll probably be a few thousand.
A few thousand? Yeah. Why would it be a few thousand?
I have the roofer coming out. He has to patch it all, put drip edge back on.
We've already had a lot of issues at this house and we're spending so much money already. This is the last thing we need.
Any other awful news for us?
No. Actually, I got good news for you. Come on inside.
All right, let's have some fun.
So this is actually not bearing.
Which,
this post.
You're wrong.
So that post you can take out.
Sweet, what about that one?
That post you cannot take off.
So I was right, it's load bearing.
If we take out this post, I have to do a pad, run beams across.
Wait. Okay. More importantly, can we get rid of this wall? How much would that cost?
You're probably looking at 3,000.
Sold.
Hold on a second. Question, Jeff.
Mm-hmm.
If we remove the entire space, we can put an island in.
Yep. Do your stove here.
I like that.
People would like that a lot with the hood.
They would.
Yeah, drop down hood. Mm-hmm. Sink, dishwasher over there, a little bit of extra cabinets.
Having a stove put into the island will be way better than having it in the closet that it was in when we first got here. We have to do this.
Here's the deal. We got hit with a lot of costs. The patio cover, the roofing, the slab leak.
Yeah, but unfortunately those are all costs that no one's really gonna see. This is an actual cost that's gonna make the house look better.
I agree with you, we should open up the space. So I guess we'll do it.
Okay, good.
All right, you're spending money for once.
All right, that's nice. Don't say I'm not a sweetheart because I'm letting you design the bathroom.
Oh, thank you. I'm such a sweetie.
I know.
What I'm thinking is...
Shower pan.
Shower pan. This white tile for the flooring, the back and front wall. Then we'll do this awesome tile for that wall.
Huh.
Oh.
I didn't say I didn't like it. I'm looking. It's literally like screen printed on there.
Yeah, I like it.
It does look cool though.
And we'll carry over the white flat panel from the kitchen, but white countertops. And then in the guest bathroom, we'll do the exact same thing.
Okay.
Cool?
Yeah.
House looks nice.
Looks really nice.
Should be interesting.
Well, I guess we're gonna find out. This house looks good. We had that weird wall running across here. Remember how dark it was? We had to take down that weird structure, but it actually turned out to be a good thing.
It actually adds more light in here.
Yeah, it's much nicer.
This is like one of the most open floor plans we've done. The kitchen actually feels really big. Like for this size house, normally you never have a huge island like this. There's tons of storage. The stove is so much better in this island than being in that weird closet. The backsplash is super cool. It looks really good.
The stagers did a good job too. I love the color combos.
Yeah, it's really cute.
The bathrooms. This came out cool. Such a unique tile.
It's a small bathroom, but it's got a big design, so it looks really good.
Super cool, such a good accent wall.
Bedroom number one.
I think we should have run the laminate in here too, instead of the carpet.
Yeah, it does feel a little bit small.
Again, decent sized bedroom. I mean, for a 1,000 square foot house, this is a good bedroom. All right, the master.
It's not the biggest master, but at least it has an ensuite bathroom.
Yeah, and plus we doubled the size of it by building the shower, taking away the closet in the hallway.
Very unique design. Buyers are definitely gonna love it.
This yard is huge. This is where that weird laundry area was. I mean, it's so much better that we put it in the garage.
I feel like it looks bigger out here. It's a great size yard. It's very quiet. It's a cute house.
Let's sell this thing.
Let's do it.
You notice the fence?
This is cute. I know, I do. I like that.
That is a pretty cool idea.
This is so nice.
I like how open it is.
Do you like the gray color and the backsplash the gray?
I do
too. Oh, wow. Little entertainment area.
Room for the dog. Very cool.
Very nice. There's an ensuite. Oh, it's perfect. Looks kind of like rustic, beachy. I like that.
The real estate market in Cyprus isn't what it once was, and our price of $679.9 didn't work out. After a month on the market, we received an offer below asking, and we finally sold the house for $649.9. We're walking away from this one with about $30,000 in profit.